Download EasyReg Advanced software at this address. Extract the downloaded software and start installation. Select your language. Select Quick Setup. EasyReg Advanced enables you to set parameters for D350, D550, and D750 voltage regulators. Today, we'll be configuring a D350 voltage regulator. By selecting the User menu, you can open a configuration file you already have. By choosing the Expert menu, you will have access to other options. New Quick Configuration. New Customized Configuration. Today, we will show you how to perform a quick configuration. All the information to be filled can be found on the alternator nameplate. Machine type. Core length. Excitation type. Nominal frequency. Stator connection diagram. Rated voltage. Service and installation class. Click on Next to access the Wiring section. The voltage sensing, referred to as generator voltage connection, here depends on the wiring of your alternator. You can configure voltage transformers, PT, current transformers, CT, or temperature probes here. Enter the values for the transformers or sensors installed on your alternator as needed. Click on Next. The values for overexcitation limitation are automatically filled and typically do not need to be modified in a standard application. Now, let's look at the machine protections. We can protect the alternator against machine faults such as undervoltage fault, regulator faults such as loss of sensing, power bridge faults. The temperature protection option is accessible once a sensor has been selected in the wiring section. To better manage event recordings, we can group them into fault groups. Each group can be assigned to a digital output, for example. Let's move on to the regulation mode. There are two regulation modes, voltage and field current. In the Startup tab, the PWM value is predefined based on the alternator's excitation type. You can optimize the alternator's operation by modifying the voltage buildup slope and enabling start on threshold mode. By default, the internal potentiometers are enabled and assigned to voltage and stability. By making the internal potentiometer set point inactive, you can modify the voltage set point either by a predefined fixed value or an analog input. You have the possibility to manage excitation current, but this regulation mode is generally used by experienced technicians for specific applications. Now, let's see the PID settings. These are automatically filled based on the machine and can be adjusted during commissioning if necessary. When the internal potentiometers are enabled, the gain is adjusted via the potentiometer STA, and in this case, the gain value will be grayed out. Configuration of inputs, outputs. This menu allows you to select an analog input, one digital input, and two digital outputs, D01 and D02 that can be assigned to events. Here, you can easily adjust the upper and lower values of the internal voltage set point and gain potentiometers. You can decide to assign the potentiometer STA to the reactive droop setting instead of the PID gain. This is possible if you have configured a CT in the wiring section. Now, let's move on to log event section. Select the events you want to record. If you want to record all of them, check this box. A reset of the event's logging can be performed here. It is possible to create a second configuration for the voltage regulator to manage different operating modes of your machine, such as 50 or 60 Hz operation. Save the configuration by clicking here. A supervision dashboard can be configured via the monitor icon. To do this, select the desired objects from the toolbox library. You can also load an existing dashboard configuration, like the one we are displaying here with the three phases voltages UVW, excitation current, and frequency. Other dashboards can be created to suit your needs. You are now ready to start using EasyReg Advanced. Thanks for watching.